This is part 32 of Azure tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss what is Azure API Management Service and why should we use it. Let's understand this with a simple example. Consider this Open Weather Map service. The URL, as you can see, is openweathermap.org, and at the moment, we are on the pricing page. It's a very popular API that provides weather data like temperature, wind speed, humidity, etc. To use this API, we have to subscribe and pay a monthly fee. There is a free plan as well, but there are limits on it, like how many calls are allowed, what data is available, and for how long, etc. With the $40 plan, you can make up to 600 calls per minute and up to 10 million calls per month. This is a little less restrictive than the free plan. To be able to use this API in the apps that we are building, we need to subscribe and get an API key. We also need to know the available endpoints, supported operations, what to pass as parameters, and what we get back from the API. The main functionality of the API is to provide weather data. In addition to this main functionality, the API should also have code to limit the number of calls. For example, the free plan only allows 60 calls per minute. So the API should also have code to limit the number of calls to 60 per minute to prevent misuse and abuse. Like this, there are several non-functional aspects that most APIs need to have. For example, caching response to improve performance, securing the API and providing access, documentation, that is, available endpoints, supported operations, what to pass as parameters and what we get back. There must be a developer portal or something that developers and partners can use to subscribe and self-service, that is, find documentation, code samples, and maybe an interface to test the API calls. API analytics is another important aspect which obviously lets you see API usage. For example, the most and least used endpoints, general health of the API, etc. Another common requirement is to package and create a facade of related API services. So all these non-functional aspects of the API and much more are provided by the Azure API Management Service. All these features are available out of the box, thoroughly tested and highly customizable. Just pay a monthly fee and all these features are available for our APIs. Just imagine the amount of effort and time it saves. So, what is Azure API Management Service? Well, it sits on top of your backend API services. It's like a proxy to your backend APIs. In this specific example, Azure API Management Service is on top of our two backend APIs, that is, Weather API and Employee API. Every call to these two backend APIs goes through Azure API Management Service. Now, Azure API Management Service is made up of three main components: Azure Portal, Developer Portal, and API Gateway. We already know what is Azure Portal. We've been using it throughout this course to create various Azure resources like virtual machines, app service instances, SQL databases, etc. We also use it to set up and do various things related to API management. For example, using the Azure Portal, we can define or import API schema, package APIs into products, set up policies like quotas or transformations on the APIs, get insights from analytics, and manage users. Don't worry if you don't understand some of these bits, we'll see them in action in our upcoming videos in this series. What is Developer Portal? Well, as the name implies, the Developer Portal is for the developers who want to consume your APIs in the apps that they are building. Using it, they can create an account and subscribe to get API keys, test the API calls, read API documentation, and even access analytics on their own usage. Finally, what is API Gateway? Well, it sits on top of your backend APIs. In this specific example, API Gateway sits on top of our two backend APIs, that is, Weather and Employee APIs, and it can do the following: accepts API calls and routes them to your backend APIs, verifies API keys, JWT tokens, certificates, and other security credentials, enforces usage quotas and rate limits, caches backend responses, logs call metadata for analytics purposes, above all, transforms your API on the fly without actually modifying your API code. How great is that? So the point that I'm trying to make is Azure API Management Service provides ton of security and performance features. For example, based on the API access plan you selected, that is free or paid, it limits the number of calls that are allowed as per the plan, prevents denial of service attacks by using throttling, secures backend services by gating access with API keys, use advanced security policies like JWT tokens, certificates, and other credentials. In short, Azure API Management System lets you transform your APIs on the fly without any code changes. Please don't worry if some of these concepts are confusing at the moment. We'll see them in action in our upcoming videos, and I promise they will be much clearer at that point. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.